Shepard, good work on Horizon. Hopefully the Collectors will think twice before attacking another colony.
It's not a victory. We interrupted the Collectors, but they still abducted half the colony.
That's better than an entire colony, and more than we've accomplished since the abductions began. The Collectors will be more careful now, but I think we can find another way to lure them in.
We have to make sure they don't abduct anyone else.
I want the Collectors stopped for that very reason. That's why we're doing this, Shepard. I'm devoting all resources to finding a way through the Omega-4 relay. We have to hit them where they live. Your team will need to be strong, as will their resolve. There's no looking back. The same goes for you. Can I assume you've put your past relationships behind you?
None of your damn business.
If it affects the mission, better you should leave it behind. Shepard, once you find a way through the Omega-4 relay to the Collector homeworld, there's no guarantee you'll return. To have any hope of surviving, you and your entire team must be fully committed to this.
Let me worry about them. You just find us a way to the Collector homeworld.
I just want to be upfront about your odds. You'll need everyone at their best. I've forwarded 3 more dossiers. Keep building your team while I find a way through the relay. And be careful, Shepard. The Collectors will be watching you.
I guess we're really gonna do it. Hit the Omega-4 relay. Take the fight to the Collectors in person. Looking forward to the action. After seeing what those bastards did on Horizon, though, makes you think.
They're powerful, but we've got a few tricks for them. If anyone can stop them, we can.
No argument there, Commander. Horizon just made it hit home. What we're doing, what we're up against. Gonna go take care of a little unfinished business. I imagine everyone else is, too. Getting some closure, you know?
Appreciate our little chats, Jacob. I really do. Alright, guys. So, the last video is a bit of a emotional roller coaster. We ran into our good old love interest, Ashley. She was happy to see us, but then again, she wasn't happy to see us. As I said, it was her objectified personality that prevented her from seeing the truth, and I guess the righteousness in what we're doing here. And she just couldn't accept the fact that we're working with servers, man. Should have told her we have a picture of her. In a fucking game like Mass Effect, we somehow have a picture of her. I don't know when we took a picture, but we have one. Yeah, I want to go to, like, check out all those upgrades that we got. Yeah, it says research terminal lab forms information. So, yeah, we're going to start off in the lab first. I really want to go in there. I want to see what we got going on. I want to go talk to Dr. Chalkwas about these scars and probably just go around and talk to some people because that's what I wanted to do in the last video before everything hit us.
From Admiral Stephen Hack at Alliance HQ.
Oh, Bishop.
I need to discuss a sensitive matter with you privately.
I'll take this in my quarters. Sure they'd help out.
Kenson is my friend. If the Batarians see a squad of armed soldiers, they'll kill her. This is serious, Commander. Go in with discretion, or don't go at all.
I'll make this a priority.
The prison is hidden underground at a Batarian outpost in Aratan. I'll upload the coordinates now. Once she's secure, confirm her discovery. We'll debrief you when you're back.
Got it.
Hack it out.
I just want to go talk to my crew. Everyone keeps coming to me with all this shit. But yeah, man, we'll definitely take a look at that. So that's what Bishop looks like in this game, huh? Interesting. Alright, do we have anything new here? No, same thing? Alright, well, I wanted to see. We got +2 Paragon there. Yeah, let's go down to the lab. Go talk to Chakwas. See what we got. I just remembered, I didn't go do the Normandy crash site thing on Omega. I had a feeling I was forgetting something. I'll definitely have to go do that, like, after this video, before I do anything else, because I want to see what's going on there.
What's the difference with tonight's meal? Seems like you put in more food and...
Commander, I very much enjoyed sharing that ice brandy with you. But I hope I wasn't too unprofessional. Brandy goes straight to my head.
It's nice to see you let your hair down.
Well... Promise me we'll share a bottle every year. The next one is on me. How may I help you, Commander?
I'll see you later, Doctor.
Commander.
Well, that was not what I was looking for. I was trying to ask you something about the stupid scars, but...
Access to the AI core is restricted.
Ah, the core. It's not a bad movie. I don't know why so many people shout all over it. That's where I heard one of my favorite songs. Yeah, there's Miranda's office. I'm probably gonna have to go in there and talk to her. She's probably got something new for us. What's the main battery? Oh, that's where you hang out, Garrus. This is, cozy, I suppose.
Shepard, need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Sure. Just checking the weapon systems. You can never be too careful. I thought I'd seen every weapon in the galaxy in our fight against Saren. Mercenary work showed me otherwise. And now Cerberus rebuilds the Normandy with a few upgrades to boot. I wish we'd joined up with them sooner.
We haven't joined Cerberus. They're funding our mission, that's all.
Relax, Shepard. Just a figure of speech. I can't exactly doubt your judgment. Not after I got my own squad killed.
How did those mercenary gangs take down your team?
It was my own damn fault. One of my people betrayed me. A Turian named Sidomis. He drew me away just before the mercs attacked my squad. Then he disappeared. Everyone except me is dead because of him. And because I didn't see it coming.
Do you know where Sidomis is now?
No. His trail vanishes after he leaves Omega. But I'll keep hunting. I lost my whole team except for Sidomis. One day I'll find him and correct that. Thanks for coming by, Shepard. I've got some things to take care of.
Good talk, Garrus. Seems like you got particularly cold after everything that you've been through in my 2 years of absence. I feel like my crew is a little bit lost. I really do.
Shepard, I find myself in the unpleasant position of asking for your help. I don't like discussing personal matters, but this is important.
Miranda, you're one of my crew. Tell me what's on your mind.
My father was extremely wealthy. He wanted the ideal daughter, and he paid a great deal to genetically tailor me. When I learned that my father was more interested in controlling a dynasty than raising a daughter, I left.
And I'm guessing he caught up with you.
My father has given up coming after me. And he's not stupid. He won't cross Cerberus. But this isn't about me. I have a sister, a twin, and he's still hunting her. Cerberus has kept her safe, until now. She's living a normal life on Ilium, safe and hidden from my father.
So you think your father has tracked her down?
Precisely, Commander. My sources indicate he knows that she's on Ilium. I've tried to keep her hidden without impacting her life, but I'm out of options. He's too close. I need to relocate my sister's family before it's too late.
What do you need me to do?
My father is extremely persistent. I'd like to go to Ilium when Cerberus is moving the family to make sure none of his agents get too close. My contact's name is Lantea. She'll be waiting for us in the lounge near the Nos Astra docking bay.
Alright, sounds like another thing that we could check out. I think this one, yeah, and this episode is definitely based around just finding a lot of side missions. I'm not sure how I feel about her saying, though, she had the unfortunate pleasure of asking for my help. I don't know how I feel about that. Alright, so let's go to the men's restroom. Hey, Kasumi. This is by far one of the better looking rooms in this entire place. Like, I give her that. Liquor. Let's pour a bottle. Let's take a shot. Why not? I bet she's got her own little personal bar in here and shit. Let's look at the rooms where Bones and Kirk were sharing a drink at the beginning of Star Trek Beyond. Alright, good. I'd imagine if you take too many, you get wasted. I don't want that. I just wanted to have a little sip.
People are talking out there, and I hear it all.
That's cool with Sumi.
They usually travel hidden away in cargo bays. It's nice to be able to look out a window for a change.
Shutter control. Why would I want to close it? Look at that beautiful view, man. Oh, I love that. It just went into first person. So sick. It's like a certain, like, feeling of fakeness. Like, I feel like this is just, you know, one of those props that they use in movies that they just put out there. But that's beautiful, man. Somewhere along those lines, out there is Andromeda, and that's where we're headed, guys. Andromeda is the mission. Beautiful. Anyway, now we're getting back on track. Anywhere else on here that I didn't check? Starboard observation is not unlocked yet. Crew quarters. Anybody else in here?
Another colony's gone missing.
Yeah, no, nobody else.
There's fields, I heard.
Access life support. To life support is restricted.
Mother, how are you gonna keep me restricted from all this, man? I'm the goddamn captain. Alright, well, I guess we're good there. So now let's go down to engineer. Let's go talk to Grunt, Jack, and Zaid. So we are now on the engineering deck. We have three teammates down here. We haven't really had a conversation with Grunt formally. Of course not, since him being thawed and whatnot, so hopefully this goes a little bit better.
Shepard.
Just checking in, making sure you're acclimatizing.
The hold is too open, not enough cover. Armor is limited. Warlord Grant would target here to scatter heavy cargo, then focus on engines. That's what tank imprints show about human ships anyway. It's how I learned from the tank. Old pictures where memory is. Like holding a book for a child. Just remember this, picture after picture. No help with finding a reason to care.
Something must move you. You're as genetically Krogan as you can get.
I see suffering, the dead, and I think weak. I'm supposed to be strong. My guts were grown from thousands more worthy. The dead were weak. If they were strong, I wouldn't be needed. I don't know why O'Kear started teaching. When he turned on the tank the first time, I screamed. Weak, pitiful.
So you started small, but you became what you are. Not everyone gets that chance.
I'm built for strength, but didn't earn it. I just am. Those dead were strong enough to try, even if they lost. The perfect Krogan, ignoring what made me. No strength in that. I'll take another look at what happened to the Krogan. Find a reason to care about it.
Well, you know, the one thing I like about you, Ren, is your look. Like, you're not like the traditional Krogan. Like, you have a very unique aspect to yourself. And of course, besides your armor, it really compliments you. So, hopefully when you look in the mirror, you're not ashamed. I really like your look overall. No weirdness. Okay, so we're still down engineering. Here's Daniels.
Cooking some good meals lately.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I'm not sure where Zaid and Jack are, but Jack, that should be an interesting conversation. I want the whole story. How'd you become that powerful? Teach me the ways of the Jedi.
thinking about past missions. Got a minute. You might learn something. Tough fight on Horizon. I fought slavers and kidnapping rings, but nothing like that. Some slavers took a little girl on a colony in the Skepsis system. Girl woke up, fought her way out, got picked up by my band well on the way to Omega. 8 years old. She'd have had no chance on Horizon.
Alrighty then.
Beauty, isn't it? Pried that off the Krogan warlord, Kazak. Used to run the blood pack out of Omega about 17 years ago. Wasn't even a job. The guy just thought he'd hijack a freighter I was hitchhiking on. Big mistake. I goaded Kazak into one-on-one combat. Took out his legs, grabbed his gun, and killed every blood pack bastard in the room. That was the most beaten Krogan I've ever seen. Kept a helmet to remind me of that pained expression.
Yeah, you sound like Kellogg, bro, from Fallout 4. It's exactly what you sound like. Alright, so I think that's it down here. Well, actually, no, it's not, because I have not found Jack yet. Where the hell are you, Jack? You're not in there. Where else could you be? This place is not that... Well, then again, port cargo... Yeah, I'm not sure. She's not in port cargo. She's not in starboard cargo. She has to be in engineering somewhere. Question is, though, where? Oh, okay. There's stairs going down. I had a feeling. I was like, that's open area. Wow, way to go, Kira. You would go for the most secluded area. What the hell did Riddick teach you?
Hey.
Tell me about you, Jack.
I'm still finding out about me. Thanks for letting me look at these files.
If they're helping you, that's good enough for me.
Don't be my buddy. You need me to kill for you, I need you for these files. Let's leave it there. Your friends at Cerberus are into some nasty things. I'm gonna find something I can use. I just know it.
What if the answers aren't what you expect?
I'm not looking for answers. I'm looking for names, dates, places.
What happens when you find what you're looking for?
I go hunting. Anyone who's screwed with me pays. Their associates pay. Their friends pay. The galaxy's gonna be a lot emptier when I'm done.
I won't let you go on a killing spree.
I'm here for your mission. After that, what I do is my business.
What's your history with Cerberus?
They raised me in a research facility. I escaped when I was a kid. Been on the run ever since. And they've been chasing me ever since. But soon, I'm gonna chase them.
You don't have to live in this pit, you know.
It's dark, quiet, and hard to find. That spells safety to me. You know, this ship is a powerhouse. You could go pirate, live like a king. I could help,
We have to stop the collectors. I don't have time for piracy.
When this is done, we'll either be dead or out here in space with this ship. Think about it. Lots of creds. Freedom to go wherever you want. And all the mayhem and fighting I could want.
What is it about killing that fascinates you so much?
I figure every time someone dies and it's not me, my chances of survival go up. Simple.
I should go.
Yep.
Yeah, just stay away from her. Don't hear her to corrupt me any more than I already am. That's funny, like, that red scenery right there, just, like, that's to show that she's a femme fatale. Like, that's all it is. It's a very dangerous woman. Someone you should fear, perhaps. Way more powerful biotics than I am, definitely. Alright, yeah, so, yeah, there's stairs going down. I gotta remember that next time. I was, like, running up and down here for a minute. I had to transition out of that. Alright, so, we did this. So, yeah, I'm guessing the only place left for us to go, then, is back to the Combat Information Center for the CIC Armory and the Tech Labs, which is where, apparently, the research thing is, and we gotta go talk to Morton Souls because I didn't talk to him. And I think that's gonna wrap it up there. Let's do upgrades first, why not? Alright, weapon upgrades. Assault rifle damage, 1 out of 5. Research assault rifle damage, review this. Another upgrade at your personal terminal. Hold on. Before I do that, can I do any other ones? Let's definitely do some armor upgrades. Biotic damage, hyper amp. 10% biotic damage, standard form of shipping bioamps is designed to work with a variety of alien races and nervous systems. Damage protection, shield upgrade. This comprehensive system upgrade offers improved protection for all squad members, regardless of team members' individual defensive strategies. Palladium required. Current palladium. Wait, palladium. What is it? Aw, man, don't tell me that that's what it's gonna take to get upgrades now. God damn, bro. Med bay upgrade. Yeah, we gotta get a lot of platinum for that. Look at that. We need like so much more. I'll definitely get that then. Because she did say we need... Wait, I think that's what it was. She said the medbay thing was in there. That's what Chakwa said. So maybe we have to do that after all. Well, that's something I'll definitely do on my own time, guys. I'm not going to show you that boring shit going around, you know, dropping probes everywhere. I'll do that on my own time. And I'll definitely show you when I get it all done so we can go see what it's like. Okay, restrain. Retrain powers. Advanced training allows Shepard to reallocate points to powers. Additional points are granted. It ain't worth it. I'm confident in what I got. Heavy weapon ammo, 1 out of 5. I need that. So, this game has frozen. Yes, Mass Effect yet again has frozen on me. Oh my god, I played myself. I thought that this freezing shit I had left behind in the first Mass Effect. Boy, was I wrong. Let's try this again, shall we? I was trying to get some armor upgrades. As soon as I hit the upgrade, just out of nowhere, like, here we go. Whew, alright. So yeah, the beauty of it is everything, you know, that I did everything that the Codex updated, everybody that I talked to, all that gets saved instantaneously because as you saw, I was going up and down all the levels, and as I said before, taking the elevator, it auto-saves at every single turn, so I'm glad to see that it auto-saves right there, so in the event that this happens again, but yeah, we're going to continue to doing some upgrades. Ship enhancements are actually pretty important, and from what I understand, like I said, resources are what you need for this, and this is what will get you that scar thing, but I mean, we're on the Paragon path anyway, so I don't know. Heavy skin wave. I guess 20% health. I'm gonna do that. Yeah, definitely. I'm trying to upgrade now. I don't want to pay for it later, guys. That's really what it is. Anything else I want, really? Metagel capacity, biotic damage. Yes. That'll definitely come in handy. And I think that's really it. Let's go talk to Morton now. What's up, Morton?
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Of course. Plague on Omega dealt with. Plenty of time to analyze collector intelligence. Impressive laboratory setup. Missed working for operations with a budget. AI in particular. Very helpful. Best setup I've seen since work with Special Tasks Group.
Is your assistant Daniel settling in all right?
Quite well. Safe and secure. Neighborhood mostly quiet with Plague gone. Left him the security mechs just in case. Can't be too careful. Also tired of mechs. Noisy. Never used them in STG.
It must have been frustrating working on Omega with such a limited facility.
No, loved it. Limited facility presents challenge. save greatest number of people using limited resources. Security threats, gangs, mercenary groups add additional difficulty. Quite enjoyable. Plague stretched abilities to limit. Couldn't have asked for more. Also, enjoy. Saving people, of course. Helping the helpless, greater good, all that too. Nice. Retirement after SDG work complete.
Tell me more about the Solarian Special Task Group.
Respected organization. Clandestine. Handles difficult assignments with limited oversight. Recon, analysis, occasional wet work, identify problems, have neutralization options ready should need arise. Model for Council Spectres based on Special Tasks Group. Very similar.
Similar in what way?
Solarians lack numbers, brute strength, military prowess, have to rely upon stealth, intelligence. Agents trusted, given wide operative freedom. Spectres similar, given goal, told to accomplish. Better funded, of course. Didn't have to buy our own weapons.
You said you were in the Special Tasks Group. What kind of research were you doing?
Not simply research. Several recon missions. Covert, high risk, served under a young captain named Kirihi. Studied Krogan genophage, took water, tissue samples from Krogan colonies.
I worked with an SDG captain named Kirihi. His team helped me destroy Saren's cloning facility on Vermeier.
Heard Kirihi died on Vermeier. Not enough equipment for operation. Still managed to take down facility. Good captain. Dedicated. Bit of a cloaca, though. Loved his speeches. Hold the line. Personally prefer to get job done and go home. Probably military bravado. Jargon. Chest pounding. No offense.
Why would STG study the genophage?
Krogan rebellion's bloody. Dangerous. Nearly as bad as Rachni attacks. All species evolve. Adapt. Mutate. If genophage weakens, need to be prepared.
What was the STG preparing to do?
Military schematics for likely Krogan population growth, political scenarios for attack points. Genophage reduced Krogan numbers. Species aggression unchecked, population explosion would be disastrous. STG helped check Krogan rebellions, needed to be ready to do the same. Simple recon, nothing to worry about.
What can you tell me about the genophage?
Bioweapon designed by Solarian science team. Deployed by Turians against Krogans to end Krogan rebellions more than 1,000 years ago. Affects every cell of Krogan body. Commonly and incorrectly considered a sterility plague. Actually adjusts viable fertility rates to compensate for high Krogan birth rate. Stabilizes to pre-industrial population growth levels.
Nice talking with you, Morden.
I should get back to work. Need to study. So much data. Here if you need me.
Well, we just had a wonderful chem lesson. I feel like he's really going to take over for Tally. He's going to take over when it comes to saying some weird shit to me for me to not understand or feeling like I'm back in class. But, yeah, so I wonder if we're ever going to figure out, like, how to stuff genophage. I thought, like, we kind of cured it in a way in the first game. I don't know, yeah, so the only person we have not talked to is Jacob. Let's go do that. And I think after that, we're pretty much done here. I went around and I saw it to everybody. Besides that freezing, which fucked up the entire episode, but...
Commander, sorry I'm a little unfocused. Personal matter. It won't affect my duties.
Always have time for my crew. What is it?
As I said, it's a personal matter. I don't want to waste our time if it turns out to be a goose chase. But... Well, I got pinged by a ghost the other night. Family.
I'm listening.
My private log got an update about the Hugo Gernsback, the ship my father served on. It sent an SOS last week, reporting a crash and requesting a rescue. Shepard, that ship went missing 10 years ago. I hadn't talked to my father for 3 years before that. I've buried everything but a body. I'm not convinced it isn't just some automated distress signal ticking over. It's been too long.
I think you'd be more excited that your father might be alive.
He wasn't around enough for me to have bad memories. It's an old, well-healed wound. But if he's actually alive and needs help... I also want to note that it's not normal procedure for distress calls to be routed to the Normandy. This was passed to my personal log through Cerberus filters.
Any signs that this was a Cerberus front? Who passed this to you?
I doubt the elusive man would let a direct operation stake hold this long. If there's a link, it's probably just about money. Cerberus needs diverse holdings to fund projects like, well, you. And whoever sent this my way covered their tracks. Someone could be fishing for favors, or thought it would get under my skin. Who knows with that bunch?
You didn't get along with your father?
He made no apologies, I'll give him that. You make a mistake, you own up to it, even if you keep making it. Whatever problems we had were a lifetime ago. I've had 10 years to get to where I am. And as far as I know, he's still a ghost.
Tell me about the Hugo Gernsback and what it was doing.
Privately held frigate. I looked over the mission brief when it disappeared. Nothing stood out. Typical research and grab operation. Find an uncharted planet, stake a claim, and establish as large a presence as you can as fast as possible to shut out competitors.
I think we can spare the time. Pass the coordinates to Joker.
I appreciate that, Commander. I don't expect more than dusty old bones, but it'll be good to close the record.
So, everything's starting to come out, I see. Everyone's starting to, you know, feel comfortable enough to talk to the good old Captain, El Capitan. And, we just picked up a couple loyalty missions. But yeah, man, I think we pretty much talked to everybody. Actually, hold on. Let me check my terminal real quick. That's something I was thinking about, because we might have got an update. Take care, Garrus. My husband was one of the men serving on Garrus' team. I don't know how much Garrus talked to you about what had happened. I don't know the specifics myself, only that my husband died in a trap set by those bastard gangs. I know Garrus blames himself, but he took every shot fired at his squad as a failure on his part, and it was clear when he sent me the message about my husband that he thinks it was his fault. Okay, who's this from? Nala Butler. From service information processing, we're aware that your old friend Liara Tassone has been hunting for the Shadowbroker for several years. We wouldn't mind helping her in that hunt. Given the Shadowbroker's past work with the Collectors, we recently uncovered some information that might give Liara a lead on where to find the Shadowbroker's base of operations. But unfortunately, she doesn't have much faith in service intel. And if you visit Ilium and pass it on to her as a gesture to goodwill, we'd appreciate it. Alright, so we just picked up quite a few little tasks. A couple nifty little tasks. And I mean, we're kind of just floating out here right now. We're probably going to consider doing something along those lines.
Sheriff's Fields. Any news on your brother?
He's gone. They're all gone. We'll get them back.
Hey, Commander. It's, pretty crazy the people you can run into out here, huh? I mean, it was probably a setup or something, but it was still good to see Ash, Operations Chief Williams, wasn't it?
We talked, but things have changed. We let it go.
Oh, good, because I was not looking forward to your mood if that went bad. There's a reason I don't date crew, Commander.
Thanks, Joker. That means a lot to me, man.
I assume everything is going well up here?
I really want a chance to put the Normandy through her paces. I just have to trim up the drive output, and it'll be like we never lost her.
Safety standards advise against manipulating drive settings while engines are powered and in use, Mr. Moreau.
Commander, can we shut this thing off? I don't need it in my day-to-day.
I'm no fan either, but we're stuck with it.
Until I find a soldering gun. There's gotta be some wires I can cross to make it hurt.
No sabotage. Understood?
Yeah, don't break the boss's toys.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Yeah, I don't even know. That still kind of bothers me. Like, I really wish. And the fact that they had the original Mass Effect theme playing, that was special, man. The fact that they knew, like, they had to put that there. That was on point. Anyways, guys, that is going to wrap it up for I think this is the second Crew of the Normandy video, correct? Well, because I was debating whether or not I wanted to start up a new one, but then again, I guess I'll just keep this as one whole video. I've also been debating whether or not I even want to talk in these, because I feel like you don't really need me. I'm not as essential to the plot of this as, I don't know, I guess a regular commentator here. But yeah, that is it for right now, guys. When we come back, I'm just going to sit back and plot a little bit, see where I want to go. Probably going to go around, like I said, pick up some supplies and do some ship enhancements, perhaps, and decide on where I want to take us, because I think we can veer off the beaten path a little bit. Maybe go check out some DLC and some stuff. And as you can see, everyone keeps coming to us with their problems. I think it's about time we uphold our responsibilities as the captain and help our crew out. So thank you guys for watching. If you haven't already, please drop a like, subscribe, comment down below what you thought. And I will see you guys when we come back with some more Mass Effect 2.